Hey guys, it's your boy. We are back with more Amalfi Javed content, and today we are taking a second look at the birdie, the Falcon, the amazing Captain America. He's fantastic, man. Like, the damage is awesome. Although, time for some ABX testing with an obelisk, of course, and with a CTP of rage. He is a fantastic character, can work with both CTP of energy and CTP of rage, although energy and proc obelisk showcase is a bit trickier. Anyways, so we are rocking 114% physical attack on the card, which is not like a lot more than the, lot less than the physical. This is the obelisk build that I have right now. Normal Urus, no Odin's Blessing, of course. All the skills are level 6. Tab Enhancement rank 4. Power of Unreal stage 12 with a critical damage 180% damage proc obelisk and 5 out of the 5 uniform options with the legendary uniform. Now, the rage build look like this. All the skills are capped out, and of course all the stats are capped out as well. No Odin's Blessings yet, and we'll talk about the skill rotation in a bit. Tab Enhancement rank 4, Power of Angry Hulk, just a CDB change to a rage, and of course a mythic uniform. We mythic it out, a little bit extra attack. Now, I will not be showcasing the CDP of energy showcase in this one. Maybe I can do that on my own account when I gave him a CDP of energy. And there is the reason why you would actually want to do that. Now, the passive is okay, but does not really activate most of the time because you are never really dodging. And the 1 and 2 are basically the fodder. Third skill is the real deal because of the freaking 50% attack for 2 attacks. 50% damage, which is awesome. So you can get that on the 4th skill as well as on the 5th skill as well. And 5th skill is the juice and the bread and butter. Reason, not just the damage from the 5th skill itself, but the buffs that it applies. 70% ignore dodge and those buffs plus the accumulation also helps a lot. And the paralysis is on the tier 3 skill. Now, obelisk. If you're running a proc obelisk or a CDP of energy, rotation is simple. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4 or... you can say 4, 2, 1, 3, 5. Get the proc on 5 skill. You have to cancel those instantly, okay? You can go 4 as well. You don't have to use those skills. I'd like to do that. Then we'll go 4, 3, 5, tier 3 here and try to get the proc on the tier 3 skill. The proc will be on the tier 3 skill and it will do humongous damage for you no matter what game mode you are playing. Alright, now if we switch to a CDP of rage actually, the rotation a little bit changes. So 3 cancel. 4, get some damage and then 5th skill. You can still get that proc, you can see the proc is still there that you can get from the 3rd skill. Then again, we can go 4, cancel, 3, 5, tier 3 is going to be the rotation. So 4 cancel, 3, 5, tier 3 is going to be the rotation. The reason why to use 4 before the 3 is the proc 50% is only for 2 attacks. If you use 4 after 3, it will trigger your proc and you will not have those on your awakened skill. Again, for you can go and get the proc on the 5th skill, but if you are running a CDP of rage, getting the proc activated and doing some extra damage with the 4th skill will help you a lot. Now, going for the obelisk run, the 180% damage obelisk is going to be this one. This is from the live stream, so sorry for the quality. So we'll go for 4, 2, 1. You can see how fast I just cancel all those skills, right? Then 2 cancel 1. We'll go 4 cancel 3, 5 tier 3. Get the proc on the tier 3 skill. Beautiful. Got the proc. And this is not the best run that I had, but again, you can cancel, and I do like to cancel the tier 3 before the end if I'm running obelisk, if I know that the proc is gonna activate. So you can cancel that. Always 3, 5, tier 3 will, come on proc, 3, 5, tier 3 will always be there to be used for the second rotation, for the tier 3 skill rotation. Now, sadly the proc get activated here, but we will be saving our tier 3 skill because it is gonna be the one that cancels, which is gonna be awesome. So we'll do some extra attack before he goes for the rover. Then I think I kind of like waste your attacks maybe. So anyways, so let's wait. The paralysis is at the very start. So 3, 5, 6 right there. Paralysis is at the very beginning of the tier 3 skill, so you have to use the tier 3 skill there. If you use that earlier or late, I think if you use that late, you can have a very hard time cancelling because it's at the end of the tier 3 skill and the end is like about 6 seconds longer. It's not gonna last that much. Anyways, so proc, okay, the proc does fire. So you can have some issues with the CDP of energy as well, but I think CDP of energy, will be just under the CDP of Rage for ABX. If you get a really good run, that could also be as good as the CDP of Rage in my opinion, and I will share why after the run, of course. So let's go. I'll have to go with the tier 3 skill here. I'll have to save this. We'll go 3-5 tier 3 here, and 3-5 tier 3 instantly get the proc, and great. I like when the proc activates at the beginning of the tier 3 skill, although I'll have to cancel sometimes, which I don't really like. So if you have the proc like a second late on the tier 3 skill, that I think is the best, because you don't have to cancel the tier 3 skill and you can actually get the proc as well. So we are getting good procs at least for now. We still have 45 seconds of run remaining, 5.2 million. Not too bad. And the proc just got activated, which is stupid. Well, it was gonna activate. So we'll go, come on dude, the proc activated. Shit. All right, we'll have to wait. 3 cancel 5, tier 3. Get the proc. Okay, the proc was late. We lost damage because of that stupid fourth skill. I should have waited a little bit more. I kind of messed it up, but of course, these mistakes will happen if you're running a damage proc obelisk on him, for sure. So let's try again. 4 cancel 5. We did not miss the proc, but the proc, it's actually very late. Very, very getting it. So we missed the proc, but even after missing the proc, we are able to get almost 7.1 million with an obelisk. 180% going towards the rage run for him. Rotation changes again. Nick Fury 5th skill, switch to Falcon, 3 cancel 4. Do some extra damage, and I kind of made a mistake. I should have used the third skill before. I didn't lose damage. Now, we'll use the 4-3-5 tier 3. Now, you can use the tier 3 skill when there are 1 second remaining. I did lose some damage because of the tier 3 skill weird activation, which is definitely my bad that I use it like that. But either 1 second remaining on the proc or at the beginning of the proc. I think those two are the timings that I like the best for my Falcon. Although I just ran this run to see if not caring about the procs will be better. And I think, you know what? If you get the proc at the beginning of the tier 3 skill, you do the same damage as you would do if you get the proc or on the tier 3 skill when there are about 2 seconds remaining. So this kind of remains the same. So we'll wait a little bit more. We'll go 3, cancel 5, 6, get the proc at the start. Nice damage, juicy things. The skill is just too long. The skill definitely is too long, and the good thing about Raze that if it activates earlier, we don't have to worry about that. So we'll go here, activate the proc, and of course, 3 seconds remaining, we will be able to do some nice damage. I tried, maybe if I can get all the procs at the beginning of that tier 3 skill, we might be able to do crazy amount of damage, but I don't really think that it's gonna be the case. We'll do all those skills, and I think we can go for one more rotation after this tier 3. Okay, so we got the proc nicely, doing nicely, nice damage, and we need to do one more rotation. Perfect, and we will be able to get the tier 3 skill in before he goes for the reward, which is awesome. So we'll go 4 cancel, 3-5 tier 3, of course, cancel with the tier 3. Proc, okay, it's late. It was late. Of course, both of the runs that I'm just showing you right now and just showed you are not really the best runs that I could ever get. Definitely the scores can be improved on both of those runs, but I would say this. If you're running a Rage for ABX, it's gonna make your life super, super easy. But I think CTP of Energy is gonna be the best deal for him. The reason for that is very simple. After this, you can see we are almost, already at 7 million right now. 30 seconds remaining. He's not gonna beat Luna. He's not meta. Luna is way stronger than him. Even if you actually don't cancel with White Fox, she can rail it through. She can just rail through it, and she can perform crazy score. She can do crazy score even without the cancel with the Domino lead with White Fox. So I guess, yeah, Falcon is great, but not ABX meta. No. 8 million. We are going to be ending up with about 8.1 million. So Rage, 8.1 million, 180% damage proc, 7.1. CTP of Energy is the best choice for him. Don't go for a Rage, ABX meta, he's not. He's gonna perform way better with a CDP of energy in all of those game modes. If you can give him mighty, awesome. Definitely worth building a character like this if you are into World Boss Legend. I'm also thinking maybe I'll be tier 3 my Falcon from level 60 to tier 3. Maybe I'll make a video and probably put a CDP of energy on him as well. He's not gonna beat Luna. Go for a CDP of energy or a damage proc obelisk. Do not waste a rage on your Falcon. He will perform way better with a CDP of energy in all of those content. Although he's not gonna be that good in DRX because of course his tier 3 will charge later and the boss would have been one shotted by then. Anyways, he was really good. Let me know in the comment section what you think about the video. Let me know what you think about Falcon and how you feel about this character. I'm loving the character. Probably I'll be tier 3 him as well. Let me in the comment section what your plans are with Falcon. And as always, if you love the content, I hope to see you again. Take care. I'll see you all in the next one. See ya.